Okay, you're all set. Now I can let it go. All right. So, before moving on, I just want to show you an interesting value graph. This is a value graph created by actually Sung Kim. He used to be a PhD student for Stanford, and he used to be a teacher here. And they, Stanford people, brought this slide one day in 2008, I guess.
And then mobile radiography. This is X-線、可動式の X-線装置, okay? For soldiers. And they created a value graph. It's interesting. So I don't think this is a good value graph, but it was interesting, so I wanted to share with you. Mobile radiography serves a Y for diagnose patient, right? And there are two reasons. Treat soldier. And to treat, why do you treat soldier? You save soldier because you want to maintain peace. And then you protect mankind, okay? And you diagnose patient to return soldier to field, to win war, and to protect mankind. This is so United States, I think. This is like watching at the US Hollywood movie. Yes, right? But this is, you know, we were, me, Sun is, I think, American-born Korean, and then we always have Kurt. Kurt Bader is a professor. We always have this guy. We always, like, you know, tease each other of being, like, American Japanese, and Kurt claims that he understands Japanese, but all he says is Ohayou gozaimasu. But yes, so we always teach each other. And then I always claim this is super American, and then this is like watching that Hollywood movie, and we always laugh about this. So this is, so even with American-minded people, you will get to the mankind level at some point. Okay, so that's what I want to tell you. And this is on your paper. This is some reference. You can actually, some of them you can find it on the web. You can, if you type it in, you can find it on the web. So if you're interested, you can read about this. All right, so moving on. So today we are talking about systems approach. So you approach things as a system. So do you agree that the value graph is some kind of system and the representation of the system? Yes, good. And then the purpose and alternative viewpoint, and then your parts were purposes and alternative ideas. And then you see an interrelation of them. Good, all right. Now moving into causal loop diagram. This is easy. This is relatively easy. Cause and effect viewpoint and cause and effects. That's what you will see. So who knows the term causal loop diagram? Okay, non-SDM people. Causal loop diagram, good, right. If you studied in system dynamics or business dynamics, you are probably familiar with the term. So causal loop diagram is, of course, cause and effect viewpoint, and it represents a cause and effect. It looks like this. I'll show you how. Okay? So this is the definition. Causal loop diagram consists of variables connected by arrows denoting causal influences among variables. All right? So I think it's pretty much easy to understand. So this is Sturman. He is from MIT, and he is the one of the authorities in business dynamics. So this business dynamics started in 1980s, and business dynamics is one of systems approaches. Okay, we talked about system thinking and system approaches utilizing system thinking principles and patterns and things like this. And systems approaches, there are system thinking, system science, system engineering, business systems, and system dynamics, and so on. There are so many related things. And this is one of them. And it looks like this. It looks like this. And I will show you what it is in detail. So there are two principles that you want to follow to create a causal loop diagram. One is causal links, okay? Positive causal link and negative causal link. I'll talk about it. And two, causal loops, okay? Two kinds of causal loop: reinforcing causal loops and balancing causal loops, okay? Oh, who doesn't okay. Do everybody understand cause and effect? Yeah? Inga kanke. Cause and effect. Okay? So, all right. So, causal links. Okay? This is trying to identify how these two variables are related. Okay? So, let's look at income and income tax. And when you are looking at two variables, you need to assume all other variables are not moving. Okay, they're not changing. All right. So, if your income and income tax is connected with this causal link, I want you to identify the relationship. What happens if income increases? What happens to income tax? Increase, yes. What happens if income decreases? What happens to income tax? Decrease. So these two variables move in same direction, right? So they have a positive link, okay? And what happens, spending, and don't forget, all the other variables are still, okay? They don't move. Spending and bank balance. How about this? If you spend more, what happens to bank balance? Decrease. And if you spend less, and your bank balance will be? Increase, right? If you have a continuous income, you will, right? So it moves in different direction. So we call it, it's a negative link, all right? So don't get me wrong. This is a relationship. So if your two variables moves in same direction, it's positive. It's not income going up, income tax going up. No. If both move in same direction, for example, income goes down and income tax goes down. So that's a relationship. So this positive and negative represent the relationship. So don't get it wrong. So spending and then bank balance has a negative relationship. That's a causal link. Now, causal loops. The number of babies and number of people, population. What is that link? Oh, it's already there. So if you have more babies, then you have more population. If you have less babies, then you have less population. So they move in the same direction, so it has a positive link. And then this is directional. So the direction means, So now we're thinking population and babies, okay? If you have population increase, then baby will increase probably. Population decrease, then baby will decrease. So this way, we have a positive relationship. So what happens when this go around and around and around? It will continue to grow or it will continue to decrease, right? We call it reinforcing loop. So babies, let's talk about the scenario, okay? How about babies decreasing? The baby start to decrease. And then what happens to the population? Decrease, less population. And what happens to the babies? Less babies. So what's going on now? Less and less and less and less. So this is R. It's not a positive loop, okay? This is reinforcing. So once this change happens, it continues to happen, all right? It does not stop. That's why it's called a reinforcement. All right, what about this? This is number of chicken, okay? Number of chicken, and then this is the number of chicken crossing road. Yeah, you look at me like that, but this is an example from the book, so don't claim me on this. So chicken, number of chicken increases, all right? And then how about the number of chicken crossing road increase? Yes, so it's a plus, okay? Number of chicken crossing road increase, what happens to the number of chicken we have? It decreases because, you know, some chickens cannot cross the road. Yeah, they became KFC. All right, so that's what happens. So let's put in a scenario. We start having more chickens one day. We start having more chickens one day. Then what happens to the chickens crossing road? We have more of them, right? However, we have more crossing road chickens, then some of the chickens will die, right? So what's happening here? Exactly, it will balance out. The chicken will increase. Also, if you draw a graph, you will. So this is called behavior over time. So if you draw graph, then what will happen? So chicken. So this is number of chickens. It will grow, and then it will saturate, right? This is what you're going to see here, all right? What happens when chickens start to decrease? Chicken start decreasing, and then chicken crossing road decrease, and then what happens to the number of chicken? It increases. So what will happen is that it's opposite. So it's going to go like that. Okay? It will balance. So we call it balancing loop. All right? So the change does not continue to occur. It will stop. It will saturate. All right? So that's you know, sachiru. Moshikuwa hōwa. All right? So that's how you name it. So two types of loops. And you want to name your important loop. So that's another rule for causal loop. So let's do this. Overtime hours at job, at work, and productivity. What is the relationship of these two? It's on the sheet, so I don't want you to look at it. What are the relationship? Overtime hours and productivity. Oh, yeah.
Tired, yes. And then they don't kind of focus on their works, then their efficiency of their working is going to worse.
Oh, really? Is that,
huh?
Is that true for your case? Not for me.
All right.
Yes, in general, yes, you're right. Yes. You work too much, you get tired and less productivity. Yes. But I work more and I get more. No. That's what my boss made me do. Right, you're right, yeah, so it's a negative link, right? What about productivity and flawless works? The amount of flawless works. So if you have higher productivity, then you have more flawless works. Flawless means good work, perfect work, right? So in the flawless works and complaints from clients, how about them? They are minus relationship, right? If flawless work increase, then complaints from clients decrease. So it has a negative relationship. Okay? Complaints from clients and on schedule work progress. It's a negative. Because if you have complaints from clients increase, then on schedule work progress decrease. Right? Amount of on-schedule work progress decrease. And then on-schedule work progress and overtime hours, how about that? If you have more on-schedule work progress, then you have less, right? So, here, now how many minuses we have?
Four,
right? So it will cancel out. This will cancel out. So what you mean is that this change will continue to happen. If you have an odd number minuses, then you will have a balancing loop. If you have an even number minuses, you'll get the reinforcement loop. 奇数の数のマイナスがあったら、これ打ち消さないので、バランシングループになります。これ、偶数の数のマイナスだったら、必ず、あの、リインフォース、増強ループになります。 So let's give it a story and see what happens. So you have less. Okay, one day, overtime hours start decreasing. What happens to productivity? This started to decrease. Productivity go? Increase, yes. You have more productivity. So productivity and flawless works has a positive link. So productivity went up with this scenario. What happens to flawless works? Increase, yes. And you have flawless work increase, then complain of clients is decreasing, yes. And then complaints of clients are decreasing, so on-schedule work progress is increasing. On-schedule work progress is increasing, then what happens to overtime hours? Decrease, right? So you will have less and less overtime hours, which is good or bad? Good. This is good. But let's go the other way around. This is the reality. So for those not working students, here is the reality. You work overtime, more overtime hours. What happens to productivity? Decrease, yes, decrease. And then productivity decreases, and then flawless works? Decrease. And then flawless works decrease, and then complaints from clients will increase. And then what happens to on-schedule work progress? Decreases. And then what happens to overtime hours? Increase. So what happens? You work more and more and more. Ask your working friend on your table. Okay, I have named this. This is, of course, reinforcing loop, right? Reinforcing. I have called this businessman loop. Because it's true. It's absolutely true, okay? So, you understand? So you find, okay, we have a visitor today who are prospective, who wants to get into this DM someday, or thinking about it at least. So, say hi, smile. Okay? Good. So, this is closed loop name, giving a closed loop name. You understand? All right? So, after you've done plus and minuses, you want to give a scenario and see how it moves, how the numbers changes. Good. And this is some example from design project. One of our design project teams gave this example to us in their project work. So this is I think. So what I wanted to show you is that it doesn't come in a simple circle usually. It comes in complex circles. It's interrelated, and different variables are connected with pluses and minuses. So what you will see in the real analysis or real design, you have to consider several different interrelationships of cause and effect. Okay, you don't get simple cause and effect. So that's only in the virtual world. So this was actually, they were trying to solve, it was a project with NTT. NTT asked this team to find a way to increase their market and also show their social connection or social responsibility as a formal public company. So that was the project. And then they wanted to come up with a new service idea to improve the marketing and then of the NTT, and also solving the social issue or the social representation of the NTT. So that's what it is. And this is causal loop diagram in academic papers example. This is a paper by Professor Bosch and his PhD student, Wen? Right, so this is another realistic causal loop diagram. This is all complicated, but it looks complicated, but they are trying to solve an issue in Vietnam, island in Vietnam. They want to have more tourism. They want to have more tourism to get more income from the foreigners. However, that will cause them a lot of trouble because more trash and then more forest damaged. But the forest is their resource to gain more people there. So there will be a very difficult, very complicated, trade-off going on to have more people in and then, you know, more trash and more trouble they will cause. So they were trying to find the leverage point. This is a key word. They wanted to find leverage point that they should focus on to fix different phenomena or to fix different loops that you want to, some loops you want to enhance, some loops you want to decelerate, right? So this is how they approached. So, okay, I won't do this, but this is a good practice example that we can do it for a causal loop diagram. For example, the causal loop diagram analysis could be try to create causal loop diagram with multiple loops for the population of Japan. Okay, what could be the variables? What could be variables? Anybody? What's that? Birth rate, yes, birth rate could be a good variable. What else?
Okay,
government income, okay, tax income, yes. Working force, yes, yes.
Debt.
Debt of Japan, yes. Which is a lot, never decreases, yes. What else?
Number of
hospitals, yeah, that could be it.
GDP,
yes. Life expectancy, yes, right.
Foreigners coming in.
Right, foreigners moving into Japan. natural death rate, natural birth rate. So all these numbers are, do you know how they are connected?
Do you know? No. If you know, you should go talk to Abe-san and say, hey, you should do this. We don't know. It's all interconnected, and we don't know where to what to do. But this is a great example of to represent in the causal loop diagram. And you can, and you know, you, before you even draw that causal loop, you know this will be in a loop. Why do you know this will be in the loop? Because, okay, because many problems do not become a loop, do not create a loop. Because, okay, cause and effect. If it rains, I get wet, right? But it doesn't rain if I get wet. Do you see? 風が吹くと桶屋が儲かりますよね。でも桶屋が儲かっても風は吹かないですよね。Okay. Are you following? So, right. So, 風が吹いて桶屋が儲かるストーリー is not a causal loop. It's a causal link. It's a long link that I cannot tell you. I forgot the story. You can ask the older faculty member who knows this stuff. Right. So, that is not a link. I mean, that is not a loop. That's a long link. All right. So, but how do you know this is by intuition? How do you know this is a loop? Yeah, yo.
And sometimes it affects each other at the same time. So
yes.
That's why it's
in the loop.
Loop.
Right. And then we have seen this phenomena for decades, right? It's been there for years and years and never solved. So such problem or such phenomena is often to be in a causal loop mode and not stopping, all right? So you need to remember, not all the cause and effect are in the loops. They might be in the long link, just like 風が吹いて桶屋が儲かる. Sorry for that not being in English, but I don't know how to they say that in English. But there are so many things that is not in the loops, okay? And so here's one practice you can do. And second practice could be causal loop design, okay? So it was a causal loop analysis. You are doing analysis on what's happening in a societal, in a society, and here now you are trying to fix this or maybe do something about this. So this is another practice that's a good one. Analyze and find a point of intervention. So imagine yourself have done depopulation of Japan causal loop drawn, okay? It's, I don't know, it looks like a mess, but you know the numbers, you know the variables, and you know how they're connected. Now, you want to analyze the causal loop and find out the leverage point. Do you know leverage point? The lever? テコの原理のポイント。テコ入れのポイントか。Yes. Yes. わかり? I thought you had a question. Sorry. Sorry.
If you do one thing, you would get the 10 as a result?
Well, yeah, kind of like
it's
that. Kind of like that. Or a point that works better than other points. Okay?
Yeah.
All right? So it's like a tsubo. Yes. All right. So, and then you find tsubo or leverage point, and then you design solutions cause and effect. For example, so if you want to intervene, some point like this, like how do you intervene? How do you increase this number? You need to design another loop to intervene, change this variable, right? So that's how you start designing causal loops. And think about the implementation. Okay, now I know how to get the cause and effect, but how can I implement, okay? So agenda could be countermeasure for depopulation of Japan could be in a good exercise. But I know you guys are smart enough, so we don't have to do this practice, but this is the kind of practice we do with our students. All right, now your turn. Discuss and create causal loop diagram from one of your concept or ideas. What? Right? So if you don't have one, you can do the wearable life log device, okay? And then try to create more than two if you have a time, all right? So here's what you need to do. is there something that keeps happening or a situation does not change for a long time in your concept or idea? Okay, so that's what I'm asking. So like I said, not everything goes in a loop. Okay, many things is just a link. Not many things comes in loop. But if you find a loop, you're lucky. Because imagine your business. You want to have your business in a causal loop. Why? You want to have a business so that it has some kind of causal loop instead of a causal link. Why do you want to have that in general? Exactly. Your customer will continue to come back and buy your stuff, right? Your business will be sustainable. Sustainable. What if you have just a big link? What do you need to do? You push, you spend money, and you get customers, but they will never come back, right? You don't want to do business like that. You don't, but all of us do, okay? Yes, there's a reality we need to talk about. But you want to design a loop so that your business runs itself almost, sustainable, all right? So that's what you want to kind of find and design. And what are causes and effect of these event, those events? So if you find some event and then you start thinking about effect and causes, and then are these causes and effect in a loop? So this will be a question you need to be asking. So for example, this is the Japanese version I created. So this is, I'll show you the name, Norikae Amitsuki Loop, okay? So Suica Auto Charge, 僕やめたんです、ある日。とんでもない額になっていて、なんかこれを認識しないで使ってるかと思うとやばいなと思ったのでやめました。で、スイカにオートチャージしますと。いいですか？オートチャージするのと乗り換えの楽さって、これはもうプラスですよね。どんどんオートチャージすれば乗り換えどんどん楽になるので。で、これゆるく作ってるのでゆるく考えてください。で、乗り換えの楽さがどんどん上がると、乗り換えが多くても意に介さない程度ってどんどん上がりますよね。つまりこう検索して、あ、いっぱい乗り換えあるけど、いっか、みたいになるわけですよね。別にだってピッてやるだけだから。で、これ乗り換えが多くても意に介さない程度っていうのがどんどん上がっていくと、もう電車代もほとんど気にしなくなるわけで、どこで何線乗ってどうなってようが全然関係ないというふうになってきて、で、これ電車代ほとんど気にしなくなるので、電車にもよりどんどん乗りますよね。で、よりどんどん乗るとよりオートチャージされますよね。はーってなるわけです。So it never stops, never stops. So 乗り換えやみつきループ。Okay? これスイカうまいことやっとんな。で、僕これあまりにも気になって、ある日改札でこうやって見てたんですよ。ほとんどの人がお金のあれ見てないんですよね。で、僕見てると結構面白い、1万円も入ってるとか。でもほとんどの人が見てない。しかもあれ微妙にこの辺にあるでしょう。だから見えないつか、なんていうのかな、こうほとんど見なくても済むようになって、この辺にあれば ETC みたいに見えるんだけど、これも多分 JR の画策じゃなかろうかな。そう、ここにあるんです。なんかしかも角度がこれぐらいしかないからほとんど見えなくて、はぁーと思って、そういうことですね。なのでこんな風なのにもちろん自分のビジネスを持っていければラッキーなわけですよね。ラッキーなわけですよね。だからなかなか難しい。 So this is what I want you to do. So you cannot find loop right away. If you can find loop right away, you're God probably. You are not human.Because you know all the cause and effect of the world. No, we don't. So just take one variable and see how it is connected, cause and effect, and find a loop. Okay? All right? Let's work on the idea you were working on. Oh, now you're in a different team. So choose a topic. Like, you can choose a new topic if you want to. You can work on the paper that you have in front of you. That's maybe...easy to do, okay? So choose your topic and try to draw cause and effect and causal loops, hopefully. Okay? Understood? Good. All right, if you have a question, raise your hand, I'll come to you. All right, I'll give you about, a little less than 30 minutes. Yeah, it's Japanese, so difficult.
So choose your topic and then start finding variables and then find their relationships.
じゃあ、ポイント解釈、時間がありそう。
So, okay, one comment, I want attention please. So, maybe you have noticed that it requires logical thinking, okay? It's cause and effect. It's not I wish effect, I wish loop. It's a cause and effect, all right? So you have to be somewhat logical to find out what will be the effect if I say it's a cause, right? Or what could be a cause of this event? So you need to be a little bit logical about, still creative about cause and effect, all right? So you cannot jump. I see some jumps. So, you know, become a little bit, be careful and get a little bit higher resolution on cause and effect. All right, a little bit careful. All right, continue on.
もう一個からお願いします。 ワーキングアワー、働く時間が増えてきて、ここだ。
Okay, let me do a checkup on you. So, how many teams have a loop? At least one loop. How many teams have a loop? No one listening, I guess. Too busy on your work. Okay, how many has a loop? You have a loop? One loop? You have one. Okay, still working on. Okay, good. You have 3 more minutes, I'll let you do it. Okay, you can continue.
なるほど、グッドラック。
Okay, I want you to stop for a moment. Please stop for a moment. Okay, how many of you have some kind of loop? Found a loop? Sort of, kind of, okay. Is it easy to find loops? No, it's very difficult, right? So, okay, again, let's do the same thing. Now I want you to try to find the insight, all right? So discuss about closed loop diagram session, both process and output. Okay, both process and output. So, and then interesting findings or new questions. So, okay, one thing you can do, if you have a loop, then you can talk about where is the leverage point, okay? Okay, that's a leverage point. Or, 押したら効くツボと押しやすいツボは違うっていうことが、これはまたね、これはまた微妙なところですね。So, leverage point that you can intervene easily and the leverage point that works better does not necessarily match. Okay? So, なんか日本語で言うとはしくるね。はい。Okay, so, and then how might we get more people go through this loop? If your loop talks about some customers, a number of customers, then how many, like, how can you get more people to get into the loop? Or how might we create a new loop so that's more beneficial for your business or your idea? Okay? So please look for insights to create new closed loop as a part of the solution, kind of. Okay? So this is you discuss your system from a viewpoint of cause and effect, right? So I want you to try to pick up an insight based on this viewpoint. Clear? Alright, move on, get your insight color, post-it notes, and you can continue working on closed loop diagram, but I want you to focus on picking up insights. I'll give you about 15 minutes.
銀行管理に気をつける。
総理とかそういうの
サファリが今の責任があるので、
フィリアクション
な
ど
フィリアクションじゃなくて、このワーキングプロダクティビティがポジションとしてプロモーションを手に入れると、仕事の中でプロモーションなのでやっぱり責任が大事で、ああいうのを合わせるのを知れば、ああいう
直接つながるかっていったら、まあ、一つのループとしては、まあ、
なくはないです。
まあ確かに。
まあまあ、ちょっと遠いですけど、まあでも1個作れたってことじゃないですか。
ありますね。
Enough about the goal findings.
How can you know that the living area increased the east area to have more? Is it just a solid? It must be a solid from the water. It's just a solid.
この時に、ああ、そうか、こういうことも気にしてもらっちゃいけないことが分かっていた。
最初あんまり考えてなかったけど、こういうのが大事だったら、そういうことを知ってたら、だから今まではこういうのを狙っていた前の補正みたいに見てたから、インターの関係っていう視点から見ると見えることがないんですっていう、その視点を切り替えてみると、急にこういう要素が出てくるっていう感じを覚えてもらうと、足し点が足しがすべきになるのかなと思います。
朝でマンダニングしてる人が多いなってイメージがあるんですけど、なんで結構高い役職の人がよくスポーツをしてるっていうイメージがあって、それは何か何かと思ってたんですけど、
そうなんですよ、参考がしてるっていうから、
大事だと思うんですよね。学生なんて何も分かんないですけど、
インサイトか
パークとか最大の
会社の支援
このループが見えたら多分対象は企業で働いている
。
マネジメント
する
から
会社がいろいろ作ってて、それを VD スで5分ディーを
待つ。それだったらハイヤーポジションになればなるほど社長職しかないじゃないですか。そしたらでもそこまでもうこのループ絞っていったら結局社長職になるかっていうイメージな
わけで、
全然あれですね。ハイヤーの社長職になっちゃうっていうと言わなきゃ社長とかそういう理解を受けたら多くの人
が多くの人が多
くの人が多くの人が確かにあるけど、例えば出席の人が増えちゃった人には多いんですか？
そう、多いんですか？
たぶんこのループだけだと思うんですけど、ここから急にそういうのがありましたね。これがハイヤーポジションにつながらないかもしれない。さらに上で行って、受けるループが見つからなかったら、そうすると、自分たちの場合は、レフェルの会社は、自分たちの会社は、とりあえずこのループを取り付けるのは助かるかなと思いますよ。で、とりあえず学んだこととしては、ループが一つだけだと弱いんですよ。複数のループが見つかると、運動する人が増えると、その複数を見つけるために、
多いな。
自分
は着替えてた。
So what did you find out? So you have created a photo loop diagram, right? That's your output. What was your outcome? Now, don't forget, now you are at the viewpoint of cause and effect, okay? And you started out from one idea, right? Simple one concept or idea, but now you're looking at different elements. Because now you see this because you're looking from different viewpoints. Okay? So now you start to get the understanding of multiple viewpoints.
Value graph was higher purposes and alternative options. Now it's cause and effect of the idea. Same idea, but different viewpoint. So it looks different, but we're still talking about the same thing. Right? You get this? 同じ話をしてるんですけど、違うビューポイントだから全然違う絵になるわけですよね。でも、まだ同じ話をしてるんです。このなんかへんてこな感じを、これで頭の中でこの何面図がどんどん統合されていくんです。で、何面図を全部こう描きながらアイディアをこう考えていくわけですよね。大変ですけど、これをやっていかないと、すごい狭いスコープのすごいピンポイントにしか当たらない、まあ、アイディアになってしまいますねということですね。だからコンセプトをデザインするってこんな感じです。Okay? All right. Who found interesting outcome? That was quick.Can you show us the thing too? Yeah.
もしコメントだったら付け加えてください。
Okay, let's hear.
Okay, so our idea is the rental grandmother.
Okay. Now it's updated.
レンタルおかんからレンタルおばあちゃんになりました。And the firstly, we drew, we described a causal loop diagram. And yes, our insight is the situation, the business people who has many workloads increases, then our potential customers also increases.
Okay, because under stress, they're under stress.
Yes, because okay. they become busy and they will don't have enough time for making housekeeping tasks. But yes, it this situation will be good for our business, but this situation will not be good for the society. Yes, so there is a dilemma, critical dilemma for our business. So our insight is how we overcome this dilemma.
Okay.
So the approach is we have to keep our customer busy. Yes, but busy not for the work, busy for example, hobbies or making growing babies. Mm-hmm. So we come up with a word, positive busy.
Okay.
So
positive busy.
Yes.
Okay.
So we make customers more busier positively, and so they enhance their quality of life.
Yes.
And we get many our business opportunities.
Okay.
So it is our insight.
Okay. All right. Good. Okay.
Another insight. Maybe this is another insight that if we have some loop, cause and effect here, it will create a loop. Profit of rental grandma will be used to invest in medical technologies. One way to create a cause and effect, but it's not so not good factor, I think. So good solution. So maybe we have to create something that our business, some relation that between our business and medical technology.
Okay.
So it will be an insight for me.
Okay. Anything to add, Elise?
We've got some questions because we've been focusing on a lot about the costs, how to increase the users and the workers, but we found it later that we still haven't done anything yet on the quality of the service.
Okay.
How to increase the user on the quality. So we have got two questions, and what is the definition of quality of our service and how to increase service quality.
Okay.
And we found that in order to do so, we dig insight in the previous board, and we found that users use our service because they want to have more free time to be positively busy with other things. So we think that this is the keyword that we have to dig on.
Okay. Anything to add?
So basically, these two concepts, so young people who want more time, and also elderly people who are kind of abandoned from the current society. So we provide with this business model, we can provide a good opportunity to both of them.
Okay, so you're matching two needs together.
Right.
Okay. All right. Yes, I like the way you put it that, so this is a hopeful cause and effect link that you want to create, right? The dashed line here. So they say that if this line was created, then this will give them a positive effect on their business, right? So that's what they think. And now they want to start thinking, how can we create this cause and effect link there? And maybe the investment might work. So this is how you look at your solution in a cause and effect field, right? Cause and effect viewpoint, and then you're trying to create your solution, right? Okay, thank you. Oh, can you put up this and value graph up on the, yes, on the board, please. Do you still have that value graph too? Yes. Okay, one more team. Any interesting outcome? Yes? Okay, Satoshi, let's. They have been fighting over spaghetti for a while.
Yes, we discussed a lot about exercise and...
What was your idea again?
Exercise.
Exercise, okay.
And we could make only one loop, but we had something about the loop.
Okay.
We believe that we need some several loops to make enforcement or exercise.
Okay.
Because there are a lot of other options, each of elements.
Okay.
So.
Oh, so okay, there are many other things you can do.
Yes.
Okay.
So one thing we need to do is make several loops which enforce exercise.
Yes.
And also we need to think several kinds of people. For example, this kind of loop is for salaryman じゃなくて
businessman?
Businessman.
Okay. Business person? Yes.
And the upper part of the circle?
Yes.
Is for young people?
Yes. Like so students?
Yeah.
Okay.
So dividing the people and create a loop for each loop is very important.
Okay, so different persona or different customer type or customer archetype gives you probably have a different cause and effect loop. Oh, okay, that's a good insight. Okay, so maybe next move will be you create different loops for different segmentation or different customer type. Yeah,
yes, then can I add about the process of the causal loop? Yeah, we a little bit discussed about the how is our discussion should be more improved.
Mm-hmm.
And the one of, for example, we should have the viewpoint of the first loop or first cause and effect is this.
Okay.
Or what is the causal, what we firstly, maybe we should discuss about what problem or what kind of what kind of problem or fact mm-hmm. we want to recognize or we should setting a goal or
okay scope maybe okay so you maybe your scope was really broad so you had a lot of variables. I think the same thing happened to maybe different teams, right? If you set your scope too broad, you have so many variables, right? You can reach to I don't know, like very far related elements too. Okay, yes, true.
Yeah, and yes, and maybe each factor has own the negative and also negative and positive effect too.
Yes.
So we should think about both.
Right. Yeah. Not only the positive that you want, but yes, some negative effect may happen. Yes. All right, thank you.
You want to
add? Another thing to add? Go ahead, yes.
So actually, we cannot find the leverage point in this group.
Ah.
I think this is because we cannot do the MISI theory. Ah. So for example, like we wrote down the getting tired, and then we think this getting tired word is a positive word, but I think there is a negative one, like getting tired, and your productivity will going to less. So I think we cannot write down the less productivity. So if we write down, so we might get the leverage point. So
right. Yeah. So right, you need to have a right variables to find the leverage point. True. Okay. Good. All right. Thank you. So, yes, I think you have got the idea of what the cause and effect their links are. And, okay, I want the answer from the audience. Do you think you can prove this cause and effect? Do you think you can somehow prove this cause and effect? Yes or no? You can try, right. This is your best guess. Not the best. This is your guess, right? And this will stay as a guess because you cannot find absolute cause and effect link. Did you know when in the full moon we have more murders? Okay? So there is a cause and effect of full moon and more murder. Is it true? Probably not. But there is a co-relationship. okay? Co-relationship. So it's very difficult to distinguish between cause and effect and co-relationship, okay? So it's almost impossible to tell from one from the other. You cannot tell whether it's a correlation or cause and effect. So who is ame otoko wa ame onna? So it is said in Japan, if you're ame otoko, it's a rainy man, rain man or rain woman, there are some group of people, like somebody who are said to be, if he or she go out to do something, it rains. This is like a myth, but it's a correlation, right? It's not cause and effect, right? It might be cause and effect, but we will never be able to actually prove that. So it's just the best guess. So why do we do this? Why do we do this? Is you create your guess and you try. You actually try and see what happens. And then you update your causal loop diagram, okay? So you will never get the best causal loop or the right causal loop ever. You will never get that. You will keep updating. That's how you utilize causal loop diagram, okay? So you will never get the right one, so you need to keep updating. And some I have written on your sheet, but it is very difficult to find even causal links, or causal loops are even more difficult. So it often requires a diligent fieldwork, careful investigation, and creative insight, or flexible but logical thinking, and more to find causal loops. Okay, and right. So that's what it's really required to do so. Okay. Any question on the causal loop? Yes. Yes.
I think. There are some level of strength of relationship between cause and
effect.
Effect. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So shouldn't we consider about that? For example, if the causal link is strong.
Yes.
Let's make the arrow thick. Thick.
Yes.
Like this.
Yes, I think that's a fabulous idea. Yes, you should probably do that. Yes, and I didn't put it here. You can go download the Venshim. It's a small software piece that you can create a causal loop diagram simulation. Okay, if you're geek enough, you'll enjoy. It's called Venshim. It's free for educational use. You can download and create numerical simulation. So in that case, you can set the weight. Mm-hmm. Set the weight on omomizuke for your cause and effect links so that you can do what exactly Yasu said. And of course, as a graphical representation, I think it's a good idea to have a, you know, thicker arrow. Yeah, I like that too.
Then we can find the weak relationship, and then here we have to do something, or here we have to find another loop or something.
Right, or you can focus on the strong relationship and do something about it. True, very true.
Thank you.
Yep. So it's really interesting to do try and see your causal loop was correct or your causal link recognition was close to the reality. So before I get you to the break, so this is what you have done so far. So this is value graph, right? This was a viewpoint of higher purposes and some alternative. And exactly the same topic and same idea or concept, but now we're talking about cause and effect. Different elements, different interrelationship of elements, but we're still talking about the same system, so to say, right? So this is the feeling of multi viewpoints, multiple viewpoints still on the same topic. And then this thing and this thing is talking about exactly the same thing. You may not see it, but you are, okay? And you want to make, okay, we're gonna have two more, but you want to make all of this work, all of these viewpoints correct, so that your idea or solution working good. from different perspective, or looking good from different perspective. And you, instead of having just one post-it note saying, hey, rental grandma, do you like this idea? And give me some money to do this. People will not trust you. But instead of that, you have, okay, this is okay, the name of the tool does not matter. You should probably explain, so this is what we are thinking. This is the higher level purposes of our ideas. And these are some possible options, but we're not taking that option because blah, blah, blah. You can explain this to your VC, venture capitalist, and you can explain your, you know, simplified version of causal links. Not, you don't use the term causal link. No one knows that, right? So you can say, okay, here's a cause and effect that we think it's really important to run our business. So this happens and this happens, and we will make sure that this will happen so that this link goes on. What about that? That's more convincing, right? That's more convincing to talk to people. Even though your idea is new, even though your idea is unheard, it's more easy to communicate and convince people. Or maybe even with your team, it's easy to understand and easy to talk about. Okay, so that's the feeling that I wanted really you to get familiar with. All right, let's take a break until 4:40, okay? 4:40, all right.